Hey, this is Fat Guy Flies RC coming to you from the mountain. Big shout out to Hobby Zone for sending me out this P-51 for review. You've already watched the unboxing and the assembly video. Now we're going to go over the radio setup. Now, this, unlike the T-28 where I took you through step by step on how to install a radio and all that, I've already done all that, and I'm basically going to show you now. So if you want to, the same principles are the same. Everything works out the same. I'll move the camera a little bit. Okay, it's the same idea. So the same steps that I took in the T28 video, watch that, and that'll take you step by step. I did the same thing here, okay? But let's just go over what I did. But before we get into that, remember on the assembly video, I had that little yellow wire? Well, it is reverse thrust.
Braking.
Okay.
Motor on.
Watch the motor. See the plane come back?
Brakes off. Braking.
That is reverse thrust. I'm going to show you how to do that, how that works. Okay? You're going to need a 7-channel receiver right off the bat. I'm using the Lemon RX Gen 2. Now, the Gen 1's had some signal issues, but these Gen 2's are absolutely locked in, and I believe in them. Fat Guy puts his reputation on it, okay? Now, got my 2200 shoved up in there, and as you saw in the assembly, that the front of the battery hatch holds the battery in place, so you don't have to put any Velcro in there. But I've mounted the receiver right dead center. Now, if you look on a Lemon RX receiver, if you look, see that white wire right there? It says throttle. Right next to that is the 7th channel that comes on these Lemon RX. That is aux 2, and I have assigned it to switch B. And it's just a single little wire, and it goes in the very top port, the closest to us, the very top of the receiver. It's just a single white or a single yellow wire plugs at the very, very top. So you'd have straight light colors all the way across the top of your receiver. And that plugs into an empty channel. You assign that to a switch. It's preferably a 2-position switch, but I had to use a 3-position. And it's automatically picks it as aux 2, auxiliary 2, because remember you're going to have flaps, or you're going to have your gears, your 5th channel, okay? And then you're going to have your 6th channel is going to be your, your 5th channel is your gear, your 6th channel is your flaps, and then your 7th channel is that auxiliary 2. Because you always get flaps, aux 1, and aux 2. So you'll have to have a 7th channel if you want to use reverse. Otherwise, it'll just be a regular 6-channel bird. Okay, now I have assigned the gear to my A switch. Okay, which is right here on the back of the transmitter. Okay, and I have assigned flaps to my D switch. Okay, so you can see, roll off of here. Okay, now this is what I have assigned. I'll show them to you. That's takeoff flaps.
Landing flaps.
That's landing flaps. Now to look at that on the radio. Okay, the flaps up. The focus there. Come on, camera, focus. Come on. Shoot, it's not wanting to. Focus. There it is. Okay, flaps up are on the spectrum system is a negative 100%. Takeoff flips. Takeoff flaps is a negative 50, and then landing flaps are a positive 50%. I haven't put any elevator to flap mix in because I don't do that until I fly her. But to show you, that's flaps down, positive 50.
Takeoff
flaps, negative 50.
Flaps
up are negative 100. Okay. Now, to show you my rates. Okay. Now, I have assigned my rates as a 3-position switch to G. So you can see G there, right? This is my high rates. 100% throws. My mid rates are 85% throws with 30% expel. And my low rates are 70% throws with 30% expel. And that is on aileron and elevator. On my rudder, I have it at 100%. Actually, I have it 125% and 30% expo on all of it. Okay, so I have one rate. So look at my rudder. Rudder is 125%. Still not very much really movement. Okay, but I did put in 30% expo, and I have chosen the innermost hole on the rudder to give you the most amount of movement. That's all you get. So you're not going to have a whole lot of rudder. But like I say, this is also a very large control surface, okay? And it's very high. It goes deep and it goes high. So that's a lot of, there's a lot of surface area moving that air. So that I'm probably going to find that that's more than enough. Okay, I've got rates. My throttle cut is on H. So, and my gear is on A. So we've gone over flaps, we've gone over rates, what I did. I do not have a flapped elevator mix because I don't do that till I fly. You'll need it if you want to use the gear, the braking, you will have to have a 7-channel receiver. That receiver also does not have any kind of gyro or stabilization of anything. What else? Okay, we've gone over throttle cut. We've gone over assigned H for my throttle cut. So I have a throttle cut in there. I put A for my gear. We've gone over the rates. We've gone over the flaps. We've gone over the braking. Really, I can't think of... I'm sure I'm leaving a bunch of stuff out. Nothing had to be mechanically trimmed other than the rudder. I had to go in there and twist the rudder linkage and just a touch to get that to line up perfectly straight. The flaps and the ailerons are all perfectly trimmed with each other. I mean, they're pretty darn close. And not enough where it's going to affect flight. And, I think the only thing left now of this model, other than flying, is to give her a nice clear coat of my Minwax. And, that'll look really good. So, you've got plenty of room. I did route one antenna down, kind of going this way, and then one antenna going this way. And that way they're at a somewhat 90 degree from each other. But, that little yellow pigtail is for reverse. Doesn't say anything about that in the instructions. And the same thing, I ran into the same thing with the new Marlin. That it didn't say anything about the instructions. You just see that yellow thing. So the only thing it could be is reverse. So there you go. That's just the basic radio setup. Didn't have any issue with her. Everything, my ailerons were reversed. So let me just show you, in case you are buying up a model and your control service is not going the right direction, let me just show you how to do that real quick. Okay, let me turn them all around so you can see it. Okay, and I'll show you how that looks. Okay, you see the ailerons, right? Okay, if you go in here, you realize, hey, those ailerons are not going right. These are, but say they're not. You go to servo setup. Okay. You go up to the very top. Scroll over until you see reverse. Okay. And then you go to the individual. Let's just go ahead and reverse it. Okay, now they're going. Right aileron is now going down. That's wrong. Okay. Right aileron should go up to turn the plane that way. So if I hit reverse now they're going correct. So And that's how you do it. If you come across one that's backwards, and that works on all. And also, if you don't like the, if you like your switch up for your gear, like I do, I like to pull it up. Well, it was reversed, so I reversed the gear, and that way when I pull up on the stick, my gear goes up. So if it's opposite, then just reverse it and then do your audio problems accordingly. All right, folks. Well, there you go. We're going. Oh, yes, CG. I knew there was something. The CG, you cannot mark it on the underside because it's right in the middle of the wheel well. But if you mark it, you start at the wing root, not, this is the leading edge. And but to see how it angles in like on a jet plane, you go at the root, where, and that's wherever the fuselage touches. And at the mid-range is 89 to 94. 94 the furthest one back, and 89 the closest in. And that's millimeters back. And you just, all you do is you just put your ruler on there and the millimeters, measure it, and then put yourself a Sharpie marks. And with the gear down, or with the gear up, because that's the way you fly, with a 2200 shoved all the way in there, pretty much CG's almost perfectly right there. Okay. Good looking little bird. Seems like she's got plenty of power. I'm going to see just if she feels like she's got a 1-to-1 ratio. Okay, motor on. And that's a 2200 with a 25C, which is what it calls for. I want to see if it seems like she wants to, that's where you can see this or not, where she wants to just kind of jump out of my hands. Oh, and she wants to kind of pull off to one side. So remember, warbirds, a little more torque roll. So she wants to go that way. Yeah. Now, one thing before we quit, we got the prop on. See, I'm barely moving a stick and I'm getting getting a response. So that tells me that the ESC is already calibrated. I went over calibration in the T28, but just to talk you through it, what you do is you have your transmitter on, have your model on, and then unplug the battery. Move your throttle all the way up to the on position, all the way up, okay? Actually, I did it in the Husky. Sorry, I did it in the Husky video. Let's just do it real quick, okay? Just to show you, okay? Unplug your model. Move your throttle all the way up. Let the model initialize. And then pull it down. Heard them first three beeps or little beeps? All right, now. See, I've got him. That's how you calibrate it. Just that quick and easy. All right, folks. There you go. Thank you so much for watching. A big shout out to Hobby Zone. Make sure my prop is secured, and I like prop secured instead of motor off. That is the Arrows P-51, the Detroit Miss. And the only thing wrong with my plane is it had that little boo-boo there. But you know what? When I put the clear coat on that, I won't even notice it. So there you go, folks. Thank you for watching. Big shout out to Hobby Zone. God bless y'all. Don't forget, stay family and friends. And Arrows. Warbirds.